This is part 17 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss the difference between public IP address and private IP address. And more importantly, why do we need two different IP addresses? Well, we need both private and public IP addresses to connect and do anything on the internet. For example, when you fire up your favorite browser like Google Chrome and then navigate to presumetech.com, how does the internet know it has to deliver the content from this website to your laptop and not to someone else's laptop or phone in your office or home network? Well, this is made possible by public and private IP addresses working together. For example, let's say in your home, you have two computers and three mobile phones, all these devices connected to the same network. Now, the router which you use to connect to the internet assigns a private IP address to each device on your home network. In our example, for the two computers and three mobile phones, the router itself gets a public IP address assigned to it from the internet service provider like BT, that is British Telecom, or Virgin Media if you're in the United Kingdom, or Comcast, for example, if you're in the United States. If you're in a different country, you may have different internet service providers. The important point to keep in mind is it is the internet service provider that assigns a public IP address to your router, and it is the router that assigns private IP addresses to all the devices on your home or office network. Now, with this setup, let's say from one of our computers, we request an article from a website like presumetech.com on the internet. The internet knows your router public IP address. This is how the internet identifies your computer. So it sends the response from this website, presumetech.com, to your router using this public IP address. Your router in turn knows the private IP addresses of each of your devices that are connected to your home or office network. So the router then forwards that response to that respective device. In our example, we have five devices, two computers and three mobile phones. So all the five devices have the same public IP address, but a unique and different private IP address. This is how the router is able to send the response it received from the internet to the device that made the request. Now, there are different terms that people use interchangeably to refer to private and public IP addresses. Private IP address is also commonly known as internal IP address or LAN IP address. By the way, LAN stands for local area network. And public IP address is also known as external IP address or WAN IP address. WAN stands for wide area network. Now, if you're wondering, how do I find my private and public IP address? Well, there are several ways. One of the easiest ways to find your private IP address is from the command prompt. So to launch command prompt in the run window, type this command cmd and then click OK. In the command prompt, type this command ipconfig and then press the enter key. There we go. IPv4 address, that's my laptop private IP address. I intentionally masked part of the private IP address for security reasons. Now, we also have something here called default gateway IP address. This is the private IP address of our router. Remember, every device that is connected to your home or office network has both private and a public IP address. Public IP address is same for all the devices, including the router, whereas the private IP address is different and unique for each device that is connected to your home or office network. So the point to keep in mind is this default gateway IP address is the IP address of your router. Make a note of it, we'll be using it shortly to find the public IP address. Fire up your web browser and in the address bar, type your router's private IP address. Remember, this is the default gateway IP address that we have seen on the command prompt. So http://your router private IP address. In my case, it is 192.168.1.254 and then press the enter key. This is the router admin page. Notice in this box, internet access, we see WAN IP address. This is my public IP address. Remember, public IP address is also called WAN IP address. Again, for security reasons, I have masked part of my public IP address. Another easy way to find your public IP address is to simply navigate to this website, WAN IP.info. It displays your public IP address. Now, here are some important points to keep in mind about public and private IP addresses. Public IP address is also commonly called as Internet IP address. It is by this public IP address your computer is identified on the Internet. If you connect to the Internet from an airport or hotel, your public IP address changes. Private IP address is private to your home or office network. The Internet or the external world does not know about your private IP address. Private IP addresses are generated by your internet router. Now, if you're wondering why we're talking about private and public IP addresses in Azure course, well, that's because to understand some of the Azure concepts, it's very important we understand the difference between private and public IP addresses. For example, I have a virtual machine here in Azure. The name of the virtual machine, as you can see, is VM Presum Tech. And on this virtual machine, I have JIT VM access enabled, that is just-in-time virtual machine access. If you're new to the concepts of virtual machines and JIT VM access, we discuss them in detail in our previous videos in this course. Now, I want to connect and remotely log into this virtual machine in Azure. For that, we need to request access. Let's request access from Azure Security Center. To get to Azure Security Center, click on the Configuration tab and then click this link. Open Azure Security Center, select the virtual machine, and then click this button, Request Access. To be able to remotely connect, we want this port 3389 to be opened up. So let's click on. And then I want to allow connection to this Azure virtual machine only from my laptop. So I've selected my IP here. So the laptop that I'm currently using and logged into Azure portal. So we want to allow connection from my laptop only. So I selected my IP and then let's click this button, open ports. Request approved. Now let's go back to our virtual machine. Click on this networking tab. Notice when we requested access, it automatically added this inbound port role. So basically it is allowing access to this port 3389 for RDP access, that is remote desktop protocol access, from this source, from this IP address. Remember, when we requested access, we selected my IP, that is my laptop IP address. But if you take a look at command prompt, notice my laptop IP address starts with 192, but what we have in Azure here starts with 82. They are different IP addresses. I am confused. Well, if you have understood the difference between private IP address and public IP address, what we see here in the Azure portal is my public IP address. And we can confirm this by navigating to this website, wanip.info. Notice my public IP address, just like in the Azure portal, starts with 82.129. Remember, the external world, like Azure in this case, knows about my public IP address but not about my private IP address. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.